Just 3 hours from Manhattan, on the eastern tip of Long Island is Montauk, New York. There you'll find a mysterious abandoned military base called Camp Hero that spawned dozens of urban legends, from widespread child abductions to time travel to covert mind control experiments. These bizarre purported occurrences are collectively known as the Montauk Project. Montauk's been an obsession of mine for over 30 years.
The story goes, between 1971 and 1983, secret experiments happened at the Camp Hero Air Force Base, which is only about a mile from here. When I was a kid, I walked along this stretch of shore here, and I didn't realize there was a base here until military personnel stopped me and told me to go the other way. And it sparked my interest for so many years going forward. I spent about 13 years investigating the alleged Montauk Project.
Local children were abducted off the streets, brought to the base, and subjected to brutal mind control experiments right under the now decaying Sage radar tower. I started my film Montauk Chronicles in 06, and in 2015 it won the Best Documentary Award at the Philip K. Dick Film Festival. The work I did on my film and the story itself inspired the global television phenomenon Stranger Things, which at one point was actually titled Montauk. It was based on this. My movie left me with more questions than answers, but the one thing I couldn't get out of my head was this notion of mind control.
Ultimately, my mission is to prove there were mind control experiments that happened beneath Camp Hero.
When I first heard about this thing and when I thought about using it, I was a little concerned because I don't know exactly what it's going to do to me.
The God Helmet was designed for scientific study of the brain, but a similar and possibly more powerful device was allegedly used to split the Montauk boys' minds. And what if that's how they erased Joe Lafreno's memory? I'm hoping to get a sense of how this process works and experience what the Montauk boys went through without irreversible consequences that could affect my mind for the rest of my life.
We're just about ready to do this, but we have to talk to Mr. Todd Murphy, the scientist. So let's give him a call.
Hello, Chris. How are you?
I'm doing well. You know, it's been a long journey, but I'm ready for this.
You didn't have any caffeine today yet, right?
No, not at all.
Okay. The first phase of the session is uncomfortable for some people.
Okay.
The other thing I'll tell you is that during the session, try and let your body feel heavy and relaxed. And don't think about what you might feel or experience. Don't analyze it. Just feel it, let it pass, move on to the next one.
Okay.
Let your mind wander, space out.
I will. So I'm ready to go, and so I'll just begin the first session, I suppose.
All right.
All right, Todd.
My thoughts will be with you.
Thank you.
very weird. It's like being in a dream state. And I felt outside myself.
That's the best way I can describe it. I'm wide awake, but I'm having a dream.
I saw a chair sitting in the distance. I was walking towards it, but I was sitting in the chair.
There was an odd claustrophobic feeling. I was walking through different places. I was talking to people. I honestly began to feel transported. It seemed very much like the future. I could feel myself in two places at once, like I was drifting apart.
I was hearing music. I started to see swirling colors, deep cosmic blues and purples.
I was laughing with people.
Those laughs turned into horror. I thought about the Montauk boys, torture, drowning, pain. Something wanted me to let go, and I began to drift away. And then, just like that, I came back.
You know, I try to immerse myself in everything I possibly can. When you actually take LSD and it's just so extreme and harsh, this is my meditation, but it's not exactly how you imagine it.
I've never felt anything like that before. But what if much more potent electromagnetic radio waves were used along with LSD and torture? Then I could see how this technology could be a powerful weapon to shatter minds.